In a time when the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the earth, God said, "Let there be light," and there was light.
The earth covered with a great darkness today, the same God is speaking. The entrance of His words gives light.
Join us every Saturday, 9 a.m. Beautiful, on Beautiful Words of Life.
As you hear words that will give you beauty for ashes.
Once again, you are welcome to Beautiful Words of Life. I trust the Lord that even in times like this, you are seeing the goodness of the Lord, because God is good. Yes. And He has not ceased to be God even in times like this. That is why we never cease to come to you with the Word of God. Mm-hmm. Because through the Word of God, we can have strength, we can have hope.
Hallelujah.
Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Jesus said that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out from the mouth of God. So God richly bless you for joining us again for this segment of Beautiful Words of Life. Always keep listening. The Bible says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Mm-hmm. What you hear can change your life. Mm-hmm. Jesus Himself said, "Take heed what you hear." Mm-hmm. We are living in a world where a lot of information are coming to us, both good and bad. But in the midst of all this, God is still speaking. And when He speaks, His word is a light that shines in the darkness. The psalmist said that the entrance of your word gives light. Don't give up. Don't resign. Don't prepare for gloom and doom. Mm-hmm. We serve a God of hope.
Hallelujah.
A God of life.
Mm-hmm.
A God of salvation.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to what the Bible says in Acts chapter 15, verse 18. It says, "Known unto God are all His works from the beginning of the world." I want you to know that God has not been taken by surprise at any time in the history of this world. When we ourselves, we don't know what to do, when our governments don't know what to do, when well-meaning people, people with good intentions, they don't know what to do, when even churches and pastors, they don't know what to do, God knows what to do.
Hallelujah.
He has a plan.
Hallelujah.
Ahead. He knows everything. And that knowledge should make us to rest in Him, to trust Him, because it is written that known unto God are all His works, not some. God created this world, and when He created it, He didn't go on leave. He rested on the seventh day from His works, but God still sees to His creation. He sees to every tiny little thing in this world. So we can trust Him, and the way we trust Him is to pay attention to what He's saying. When we listen to God's word, we are saying that, God, we trust You.
Hallelujah.
So I believe that that is what you want to do, but that's why you are listening to us. God richly bless you. And I want us to have a word of prayer before we go into today's beautiful words of life. So Father, we thank you and we give you the praise. Indeed, known unto you are all your works from the foundation of the world. You are the architect of this universe. You have the plan. You've seen it all. Nothing takes you by surprise. I pray that you will help us to trust in you. That is all we have to do, to simply trust in you. I thank you, Heavenly Father. I give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. God richly bless you. And it's my pleasure once again to come to you with today's beautiful words of life. And of course, it is the Word of God. When you tune in here, what you hear is God's Word. We have nothing of our own to give you, but such as we have received, that we give unto you. And it's the very Word of God. We've been making a tremendous journey, and by God's grace, it has been beautiful. Today, I want to talk about something very important. Jesus said something that when the Son of Man comes on the earth, shall he find faith on the earth? Will he find faith on the earth? These are the days of unbelief on rampage. There is an epidemic of faithlessness, of unbelief. But what pleases God is faith. Hebrews chapter 11, the verse number 6, he says, without faith it is impossible to please God. He that comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Don't quit on God. Have faith in God. When the Son of Man comes, let him find that you are one of those who had faith. And faith in him. And faith in him is faith in his word.
Hallelujah.
So today's beautiful words of life, we're talking about the life of faith. The life of faith. And it's coming from our book, The Spirit-Filled Life, The Quest for Supremacy. I want to recommend this book to every one of you out there. It's going to be a great blessing to your life. The life of faith.
The life of faith. Union with Christ in the sweet spirit of grace by faith is the mystery of our triumph.
That is a quotation from the chapter of this book, The Life of Faith. The life of, incidentally, I realize is, you know, it's chapter 11.
Yes.
Hebrews chapter 11 is a classic chapter of faith in the Bible. You know, without faith it is impossible to please God. It's found in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And here we are. I've never seen it that way. Chapter 11,
yes,
the life of faith. So welcome to chapter 11 of your life, the life of faith.
Hallelujah.
Union with Christ in the spirit of grace by faith is the mystery of our triumph. That is what Christianity is all about. It is union with Christ. Union with Christ. You know, you see, when we met, you had your second name from your father. But that name changed because of the union that we had. And that's exactly what happens when we met Christ. Our name changed. In fact, the Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. All things are passed away. Behold, all things
are become new.
Hallelujah. Union with Christ in the spirit of grace by faith is the mystery of our triumph.
Hallelujah. This is the marvel of faith. It is instant.
That's it. It is instant. The marvel of faith. It is instant. Microwave came to meet God's wave.
Hallelujah.
It's the faith wave.
Yeah.
Yes. It happens instantly when we believe. The marvel of faith is that it is instant. Hallelujah. God gives us an instantaneous experience or blessing mm. or manifestation mm. of his grace, of his power.
Mm.
Yeah.
When a man hears the word of God and his heart believes, there's an instant reaction.
That's it. When a man hears the word of God and, he, and his heart believes, with the heart man believes. Mm. We don't believe with our head. We believe with our hearts. Mm. And when you believe, there is an instant reaction. Mm. Paul the Apostle said in Romans chapter 10, mm. that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and shalt believe in your heart mm. that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Mm. And that is instant.
Mm.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Similarly, when a man believes on Jesus, at that same instance, a miracle of God takes place.
That's exactly what I'm talking mm. about. When a man believes in Jesus, at that same instant, a miracle of God takes place. A miracle of God. Oh, a miracle of God. Salvation.
Mm.
It happens at the instant of faith.
Mm.
I am saved. Mm. I was a sinner,
mm.
a wretched sinner.
Mm.
But at the instant of faith,
see.
You know, when you read your Bible, what consistently happens is that when people ask the apostles, what must I do to be saved?
Mm.
They did not hesitate
mm.
to tell them what it takes to be saved. Immediately they go straight away. Mm. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Not that you are going to be saved. You get saved.
Mm.
You believe and then you are saved.
Hallelujah.
And I want to tell you out there, you don't even have to wait for us to come to the end mm. of this session.
Mm.
Believe on the Lord Jesus mm. Christ and thou shalt be saved.
Mm.
It's as simple as that.
Mm.
That miracle of God will take place in your life.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. By that faith reaction to the word of God, which is Jesus Christ himself, he receives eternal life.
Yes.
The very life of God comes into him. Prior to that, he was alienated from the life of God.
Yes. When by faith,
mm-hmm.
by faith reaction to the word of God,
mm-hmm.
which is Jesus Christ himself, mm-hmm. we receive eternal life. Is that not what the Bible says?
Mm-hmm.
For God so loved the world
mm-hmm.
that he gave us his only begotten son.
Mm-hmm.
That whosoever, think about it,
mm-hmm.
whosoever believes on him. Listen, time is running out for this world.
Mm-hmm.
Time is running out of this world for this world,
mm.
and this is the day of salvation.
Mm.
Tomorrow might be too late.
Mm.
As you are hearing us, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt have eternal life. You will not perish,
mm.
just as the Bible says.
Hallelujah.
You will receive
mm.
eternal life, and because prior to that, you were alienated from the life of God. You didn't know anything called eternal life.
Mm.
Ephesians chapter 4 verse 18.
He says, having the understanding darkened, being annihilated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their hearts.
We don't want you to be ignorant anymore. See, this thing we are talking about, you don't go to school to get it.
Mm.
Yes. You don't travel to get it.
Mm-hmm.
You hear God's word to get it. The entrance of thy word, it gives light. The Bible says, having the understanding darkened.
Mm.
Who are they? The world.
Mm.
A man without God, without Christ,
mm.
being alienated, separated,
mm.
cut short
mm.
from the life of God, which is eternal life,
mm.
through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart.
Mm.
But today the Lord is opening your eyes.
Mm.
That is why God told Paul when he commissioned him, he said, go and open their
mm-hmm.
eyes. It doesn't mean that they were literally blind.
Mm-hmm.
But man's heart was closed
mm-hmm.
to the life of God. And God, through this man, was going to open their eyes so that they will receive.
Mm-hmm.
They will see
mm-hmm.
eternal life.
Wow.
Yes.
But we are talking about another life, a new life called eternal life, which a man receives by faith according to scriptures.
If the life of faith does not bring you eternal life, you don't have anything yet.
Mm-mm-mm.
We are not talking about faith for something, you know, all of that follows.
Mm-hmm.
But the reason for faith mm-hmm. is eternal life. Mm-hmm. The ultimate in believing mm-hmm. is eternal life.
Hallelujah.
Not you believe to have a shoe, you believe to have a house.
Mm-hmm.
No, that may happen, mm-hmm. but what is certain
mm-hmm.
is that you have what?
Eternal life. Hallelujah.
You don't perish.
Mm-hmm.
That is the value, the reason mm-hmm. for faith, the life of faith. Yes.
He had no trace of that life, nor showed any signs and hopes of it.
Yeah, we're talking about our former life.
Yes.
There was no sign mm-hmm. of this mm-hmm. thing we are talking about, eternal of eternal life. There was nothing like that.
He didn't know what it was until he believed and received by
faith. He didn't know. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes when you were a Christian and then you look at your life mm-hmm. before you became a Christian and mm-hmm. after, you wonder what you were doing. which forest were you
mm-hmm.
in?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And you may have been a moral man.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because Christianity is beyond ethics.
Mm-hmm.
It's beyond morality.
Mm-hmm.
We are talking about something mm-hmm. of God. You know, because some people are like, I don't smoke. I don't do this. I don't do that. So what is the purpose of me becoming a Christian?
Mm-hmm.
It's more than that.
Mm-hmm.
You are marching straight to destruction mm-hmm. with all your good works.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So he's saying, don't ever think somebody looks likely to be saved whilst another person looks likely to be damned.
Yes, this is another thing we have to, you know, look at. Because we don't get saved by all these good works and good looks.
Yes.
You know, so you look at this person and say, oh.
Yeah, this person is good in himself.
Yes, so. He looks like he's a potential for salvation. There's nothing like that.
Yes, so nobody is at an advantage.
Yes.
Mm.
All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The nice looking and the not so nice looking, according to our own, you know, calculations.
Mm.
The educated, the not so educated, poor, rich. Salvation is not a matter of looks, race,
temperament.
It is the faith in the Son of God that saves. Believe and be saved. Believe and be saved. And I will read it again, unashamedly, because I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. John 3:16. Can we read it together? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. God sent us to tell you that. Yes. That he has sent you his only begotten Son. Forget about all that is going on in the world. There is good news. You may not hear it on the media. You may not have it on any channel. They may be peddling falsehood, lies, but there is a good news. The gospel of Jesus Christ has not changed. It has not failed under this present world crisis. God still loves you. He loves you. And the proof of that love is the Son that he gave. Yeah, people have shared rice, shared what have you, this season. There is a greater love than that. It is the love of Almighty God expressed in his Son Jesus Christ, that whosoever will believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. I thank God that I have believed.
Hallelujah.
And I have eternal life.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Ephesians 2:8.
For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God.
Mind you, we are talking about a life of faith. He said, for by grace are you saved through faith. You know, we said from the beginning, union with Christ in the sweet spirit of grace by faith is the mystery of our triumph. When we believe in God, I mean, to believe in God is to be of all men the most triumphant, most blessed.
Hallelujah.
And how does it happen? Through faith, not of yourselves, it is the gift of God.
Hallelujah.
It's amazing that even now, you know, people are still trusting in other things to be saved. The songwriter said, I need no other argument. I need no other plea.
It is
enough
that
that Jesus died,
and that he died
for me. Listen, he died for you. Through faith, you can receive that gift of God, which is eternal life, which is salvation. You don't need holy water to be saved. Yes. You don't need some piece of a handkerchief. It's just a piece of a cloth. It can't even sew a dress for you. So why do you need it? Why do you have to put your trust in it? You don't need some, you know,
handbands
and all of those things. It's not necessary. For by grace, what is grace? The favor of God. God's favor. His unmerited favor. Are you saved?
Through faith, the life of faith. And that not of yourselves, it is
the gift of God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Eternal life is not something gradual, but instant upon believing on the Son of God.
Yes, it's not gradual.
It is a miracle of God. It is the life of God coming into the heart of man to make him alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Hallelujah.
According to Romans 6.
The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 2 that, and you has he quickened. You know, he has raised you up. You were dead in sins and trespasses. Now, how did that quickening happen? The Bible said that we have been raised from the dead by the operation of the faith of God. And when we believe, God has faith in what he has done. And when we believe in what he has done, by the operation of the faith of God, we come alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. And it is instantaneous.
Hallelujah.
You just come to life.
Hallelujah.
In God.
Hallelujah. The point is, when a man believes by God's grace, it just happens at the very instant he receives eternal life. In fact, God becomes his life.
God becomes his life. Yes, he becomes his life. John chapter 1 verse 12.
But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believed on his
name. Even to them that believe on his name. I have nothing sophisticated for you other than this word of faith which I am preaching, which I am declaring unto you. Yes. I'm not behind a pulpit, but I am preaching to you. It's not a pulpit that makes a preacher.
Yeah.
It is the word of God that makes a preacher.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Again, it is written, according to Colossians chapter 3, verse 4, when Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory.
Mind you, we said that when you believe, God becomes your life. And that is what we are trying to see from the scriptures.
Hallelujah.
That as many as receive him, to them give you power to become the sons of God, even though they believe on his name. And then when Christ, who is our life,
shall appear,
then shall he also appear with him in glory.
Hallelujah.
1 John chapter 5, 11 and 12.
And this is the record that God had given to us eternal life. And this life is in his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son hath not life.
Yes. The record that God has given to us is what? Eternal life. And that life is in his Son. It's not in a bottle. It's not in a handkerchief. It's not in a device. It's not in a man. He that has the Son,
he has life.
And he that has not the Son of God has not life. It's as simple as that. You can't kick against it. God has spoken, and that's it. Yeah.
The believer in Jesus begins to live by God now.
Yes.
And when you believe, you keep on believing.
You begin to live by God. That instant experience that you had,
you continue in it
by faith. You walk continuously by faith, the life of faith.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He begins to live by Jesus Christ now. He is enabled by the Holy Spirit with the life of God now. The miracle of eternal life is instant.
Yes, take notice of that word now. Everything is now. The Bible says, beloved, now are we the sons of God. Now.
When God saves you, he saves you, and it is now. Yes.
The miracle of eternal life is instant. It is instant by faith. This is the marvel of faith. Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ is to believe that he saves you now.
It's to believe that he saves you now. Right now. right here, right now, on Beautiful Words of Life.
Wow.
And if you believed on Jesus, you are believe already in Jesus. Believe it. Don't shake. No. Keep your assurance of salvation there. He saves you now. Mm. There is a man of God I like by name A.B. Simpson. Mm. He's going to be with the Lord. He loved to tell people. He says, we do not meet at mercy's gate to knock and weep and watch and wait. For mercy's gifts are offered free.
Hallelujah.
And she has waited long for thee.
Mm.
When you go to somebody's house, I mean, just a knock and then they respond and then they come in and fetch you, bring you inside. God must be smarter than the human beings he made. That when we knock at his door, we come at mercy's seat, we do not need to tarry, weeping, hoping that he'll come and save us. No, he saves and saves instantly. May your response be that I will hasten to him. I will hasten so glad and free. Jesus, blessed Savior, I come to thee. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus saves, and he saves at the instant of faith. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved.
Hallelujah.
I want to commend you unto God and the word of his grace and of his faith which you have heard today. If you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, believe on him right now and you'll be saved. Right now. I don't care whatever you've done. What he has done is greater than whatever you have done. He said, for by grace are you saved through faith. All you need is that faith. And by his grace you shall be saved. Can I pray with you right now? Father, I thank you for everyone out there. You have heard the word of faith. And now, Lord, you are saying, I believe. Yes, let them know that you save even now at the instant of faith. I thank you, Heavenly Father. Because he who comes to you, you will not in any way cast out. I give you praise. And I pray, Lord, for faith to rise in the hearts of your people in times like this. But should you come any moment, you come and meet us in the faith, living the life of faith, a victorious life, a life of triumph. When the Son of Man comes, may he find faith in us. I give you praise. I thank you, Heavenly Father, for answered prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. God will bless you. And in case you have any problem, this same faith is the victory. Amen.
Amen.
This same faith will bring you a testimony. The Bible says, who is he that overcomes the world? This world, with all this wickedness and darkness, these uncertainties, the Bible says, he that believes that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Welcome to a life of faith. Indeed, union with Christ in the sweet spirit of grace by faith is the secret of our triumph. Live on, you are triumphant through Christ Jesus our Lord.
Hallelujah.
And faith is what makes it happen.
Hallelujah.
God richly bless you, and until we meet you again,
it is think beautiful, talk beautiful,
and live.